I think she love me, cause I got the check on me. Won't spend it then flex on me. Put a curse, a hex on me. Scratch out my name, put the X on me. You should come check on me. Talk dirty and caress on me. Fucking might as well get undressed for me. Love, how you get that pussy wet for me? Put a lot of stress on me. You used to obsess for me. Call the station and request for me. You don't win and gotta.
Hey fairies, and welcome back to my channel. It's Laurice Andrea. So I'm just going to show you guys what exactly you will need for this 360 wig. You're just going to need a foam mannequin head, a mesh wig cap, some T-pins. You're also going to need some clips, some scissors, a comb, and a needle and thread. So I'm just putting the mesh wig cap on. I really like to use a mesh because it just allows my hair underneath to breathe whenever I'm wearing my wigs. And I'm just showing you guys the 360 frontal. This is from my first wigs. And I got three bundles of 22 inch and then a 22 inch 360 frontal. But I only ended up using about 2.5 bundles. So the 360 frontal comes with two wig combs in the front, one wig comb in the back. And then you also get adjustable straps inside. So I think the easiest way to put on your frontal is to section off the hair and then braid it so that the hair is out the way. So that's just what I'm going to be doing right here. So now I'm just going to move on to sewing down my frontal. So I actually ended up messing up for this part. So basically, long story short, I never did 360 frontals before or 360 wigs before because I just always felt like the actual 360 frontals were a little bit too large for my small head. I swear that I have a 20 circumference head. I'm not even joking, guys. I'm like so serious. But basically, the easiest way for me to do this and to adjust it to my head is to cut off the excess lace on the frontal and then start to sew it down. And then when I start to get to like the little wacky parts where it's like kind of folding over and it has like excess parts, I like to fold that over and then continue to sew. So that's basically what I learned to make the frontal a little bit smaller and to fit my head. So off camera, I just adjusted the straps in the bottom of the frontal to fit my head. You definitely want to make sure that you are doing that before you sew down your frontal on the wig cap. So once you have that done, you can just sew it down on the wig cap and then you're good to go to sew on some bundles. So now I'm going to go ahead and start sewing on my bundles. So in the back, I'm going to be doing single wefts, and then in the middle, I'm going to be doubling the wefts. So I'm going to do about 4 rows of single wefts, and I'm not cutting this. I'm going to be cutting the middle part where I double it, but in the back I'm just going to be doing the fold over method. I'm just going to start by sewing on my first track, and then when I get to the end, I'm going to fold it over and pin it down with a T-pin because it just creates a nice little guideline for me. And then I'm going to start to sew in the opposite direction.
Thank you.
have 4 tracks down. I'm just going to measure out the track and then pin it with my T-pen. And then I'm going to get another bundle from the 22 inch because I got 3 of them. So the extra bundle I'm just going to use to double off my wefts. So I'm just going to put that over top of the other weft that I had and then let that hang from the T-pen. And then I'm just going to start to sew those together. And then when I get to the end, I'm just going to cut off that doubled weft and then start to do the single weft again and then fold it and then basically do the same thing. So I'm only going to be doubling in the middle, and then at the top and the bottom of the wig, I'm going to be having single wefts. So I'm just going to be doing the same thing, doubling the weft, probably about 3 or 4 rows of this. And then when the 4th row it's done, I'm going to go back to doing my single wefts and then closing off the wig. The frontal does come pre-plucked, but you guys know I just like to go in and pluck a little bit more just to make it a little bit more natural and just makes it look super seamless. So since this is targeted to my beginners out there, and even I just do this because I'm lazy and I just feel like tinting is just not a necessity anymore, I just like to take some of my foundation in a beauty blender sponge and just put that on the inside of the frontal on the lace part. It just makes it so you don't have to do the tinting process and you can just get the exact color of your skin on your scalp. So as you guys can see, I did leave on the wig cap. It just makes it so that the wig is just nice and snug on my head and I don't have to sew on any adjustable straps or anything. And it just basically takes out one extra step. So you're taking out sewing on the strap and then you're taking out tinting your lace. This is a beginner's video, so we're trying to make it nice, clean, cut, and short for you guys. As easy as pie. So I just wanted to show you guys that this is a free part frontal wig, so you can part it anywhere that you want to create that seamless natural look. And I'm also going to show you guys the ends of the hair. This is how the hair came. It is just amazing, like amazeballs at like how good the ends are, and it came like this curled kind of look to it. I don't know if they pre-curled it before they sent it to me or if that's just how it just naturally comes, but it's just so amazing and it just is bomb. So I'm just going to put on the wig again and start to cut my lace to my hairline. So you can use either scissors or a razor. I would definitely say please be careful if you're using a razor. I've just been doing this so many times that I pretty much mastered it, and I just like the effect with the razor instead, so I'm just going to use a razor. But like I said, please be careful if you do decide to use a razor. If you want to be safe, just use some scissors, guys, seriously. So I'm just going to go ahead and start to cut it to my natural hairline, and I'm not cutting it literally on my scalp. I'm pulling the lace away from my scalp and then start to cut it so that it's not even touching me at all. And I'm just going to do this for the whole entire hairline. So my clip kind of got lost, but all I'm doing right here is just getting a little bit of my got to be gel and then using my free spray and then laying down my frontal. You definitely actually can skip this part because we left the wig cap on. The wig is already nice and secure, but you guys know, I just like to make sure that my wig is nice and good on my head, and it just makes it easier to lay down my baby hairs when I do this part. And then I'm also going to glue down the back. So I'm not putting it on my actual hair. And I repeat, I am not putting the glue on my hair. I'm putting it on the actual strap from the elastic band inside of the frontal. And I didn't notice that I did have a little bit of excess lace on the back. And I actually went to cut that off after this clip because I noticed that it was still on. But I'm just putting it on the elastic band inside of the frontal. And then I'm just letting that dry. And then we're good to go after this part. So just make sure that you are gelling down the back so that it is nice and secure when you put your hair in a ponytail and it's not lifting up at all. So right here, I'm just taking that same blade and I'm creating some baby hair. And then I'm going to take my Gorilla Snot Gel and then lay that down with my brush. So I've showed this a couple times in a few of my videos, but I just love to take my Charlotte and Bloom palette from Tarte in the shade Rebel. It's literally the same exact color of my skin tone, and I like to put this on top of my lace after it's dried for about 10 minutes because it just blends right in with my skin, and this is my key to making my frontals look absolutely super realistic. So basically, in these last few clips, I'm just going to be doing different styles that I decided to do with the wig. So I'm putting it in high ponytails, low ponytails, I'm braiding it. I'm basically doing everything possible that you can possibly do with this hair. Now, I am partnered with My First Wigs as well. So if you guys want to see this wig on their website to be sold, you know, we will talk about it, but I kind of just want to see how this video does before we discuss selling this wig on their website. So if you guys want to see this wig sold on their website so that you don't have to make a wig yourself, we can talk about that, but I just wanted to make a video just to show you guys just how easy it is to make a 360 wig. You know, I was always scared of it myself, but when I noticed how easy it is, it actually takes a lot faster to make a 360 wig than it does a regular wig. I got this wig done in about 40 minutes, and the average wig for me to do takes about 3 hours. So yeah, this will definitely be my go-to as far as making my wigs and making 360 wigs instead of like regular degular schmegler wigs. So like I said, if you guys want to see this wig sold on their website, we can talk about that, but I just kind of want to see you guys' feedback before we discuss that you know, out behind scenes. So you guys, that pretty much concludes the entire tutorial. I hope you guys really do like it. This was my first time ever making a 360 wig, and I think I did pretty good. Don't mind the lint that I have on the right side of my hair. I do notice it, so you guys don't really have to pick that out. I do see it. So if you guys really enjoyed this tutorial, definitely give this video a thumbs up, as well as turn on that notification button, and definitely stay tuned for my giveaway for my 100K, because that will most likely be up next week. This video should be up on Sunday, if I'm not mistaken, so it will definitely be on my channel next week. So definitely stay tuned for that, and as always, I love you guys, and bye.